Hello there, my friends. Thanks for joining me. I was just having some lunch. Have you eaten today? I wonder if you want to share some food with me. I'm going to show you some food and you tell me if you would eat it, okay? Let's see. I was just eating a nice old carrot. Do you like carrots? I see a couple people. All right. Would you eat a banana? Okay. Most people will eat a banana. All right. Would you eat an apple? Yeah, I think lots of people would eat an apple. How about a hamburger? All right. Would you eat corn? I think some people don't like corn because it gets stuck in their teeth. How about blueberries? Would you eat blueberries? Is that something you like to eat? Okay, how about cake? What? Some of you don't like to eat cake? Wow, I need to talk to your parents. How about broccoli? No? What? Broccoli is the best. Little trees. Well, did you know that the Jewish people have laws about certain foods that they can and cannot eat? Did you know that? And in today's Bible story that we'll be watching in a little bit, God told Peter to eat meat from animals that were against Jewish laws to eat because they were considered unclean. I wonder why God said that. Well, let's listen to our Bible story and find out why. Okay, but before that, I want us to find our Bibles. Can you go find a Bible? I'm gonna go find mine. All right, does everyone have their Bibles? You wanna show me? Okay, I think I see some Bibles. Well, this is my Bible. And today, for our Bible story, we are going to be in the book of Acts, which is in the second half of the Bible, which is called the New Testament. And it's in the book of Acts. We've been in this book for a little bit now. But this week, we're in chapter 10. Okay, so that's the big number there. Okay? And we're reading about Peter and Cornelius. So we're gonna read through the book of chapter 10. And for my older friends, I encourage you this week to read through chapter 10, maybe with your parents, okay? And we know that the stories that we're learning today and every week are true because these are God's words from the Holy Bible, okay? Now, before Jesus came, God's people had a lot of rules to follow. Do you guys like following rules? I think some of us do. And one of the rules was that Jews were not supposed to eat the animals that Peter has a vision about. And we're going to see that soon in our Bible story. But God made them clean. And just like God made the animals clean and safe to eat, God can also forgive anyone's sins and bring them into his family. And God showed Peter that the good news about Jesus is for everyone. Okay? God wants believers to tell everybody about the good news of Jesus, no matter who they are and no matter what they do, because Jesus is the Lord of all people. I want to remind us that we've started a new unit, Unit 31, and the key passage for this entire unit comes from the book of 1 Chronicles. 1 Chronicles is in the first half of the Bible, or the Old Testament, and it comes from chapter 16, verse 31. And I encourage all of you, my friends, that this is going to be our Bible verse that we're going to try to memorize together. Okay? So I'm going to read it to you. Let the heavens rejoice, let the earth be glad. Let them say among the nations, the Lord reigns. That is our Bible verse from 1 Chronicles. Now, when the Bible says the nations, okay, it doesn't say just a certain area of the world, it means everyone, everywhere, okay? Our key passage says that the whole world should praise God as their king. Okay, so that is our Bible verse for this week. I encourage you to start memorizing it. And we're going to sing a song about our key passage called The Lord Reigns and the theme song for this unit, which is called The Gospel Is for Everyone. Okay? So you guys ready to do some singing and dancing? All right, let's go.
friends, it's me, Megan, and Jesse.
Jesse, I'm so excited for today's Bible story. This story is about when the gospel began going to the Gentiles.
Gentiles? We have blue tiles in our bathroom.
Gentiles are actually people, not a kind of tile. Gentile is a word for someone who is not a Jew.
Oh, well, what's the difference between a Jew and a Gentile?
That is a great question, Jesse. Remember, the Bible tells us that Jews were God's special people, the people of Israel. God gave them special rules to follow as his special people.
Oh yeah, I do remember that.
Yep, but God had a plan to make Gentiles part of his special people too. They did not have to be born into a Jewish family to be God's people. Gentiles can be part of God's people simply by believing in Jesus.
That's good news.
Yep. Listen to this story about when a Gentile soldier and his family trusted in Jesus. Cornelius was a Roman soldier. He loved God, helped other people, and prayed to God. One day, God sent an angel to Cornelius. The angel said, "Cornelius, God heard you when you prayed." The angel told Cornelius to send some men into the city to find Peter. So Cornelius sent two servants and one soldier into the city. In the city, Peter went up on the roof of a house to pray. Then Peter saw a vision. A vision is like a dream, but Peter was awake. He saw a big sheet coming down from heaven. In the sheet were all kinds of animals, snakes and lizards and birds. A voice said, "Get up, Peter. Eat." But Peter didn't want to. He thought the animals were unclean. A voice said, "God has made these clean." Peter saw the vision three times, and he tried to figure out what it meant. Then the men Cornelius sent into the city found the house where Peter was staying. They told Peter to come to Cornelius's house. So the next day, Peter went with the men. When Peter saw Cornelius, he told him that the good news about Jesus is for all people, not just Jews. "Everyone who believes in Jesus will have their sins forgiven," Peter said. The people there believed. Cornelius, his family, and his friends were baptized, and Peter stayed with them for a few days. God showed Peter that the good news about Jesus is for everyone. God wants believers to tell everyone the good news about Jesus, no matter who they are or what they do. Jesus is the Lord of all.
Well, just in case we could use a little downtime, I'm going to ask you guys to find a spot on the ground and lay on the floor and just close your eyes. Okay, go ahead and do that right now. Just find a comfy spot. Or if you're seated really comfy on the couch, that's okay too. You just close your eyes. Okay? And I'm going to invite you to think about your favorite place in the world. It could be your favorite place in your house, or maybe somewhere you visited, or maybe your grandparents' house. Think about your favorite place in the world. Okay? And I want you to think about, what does this place look like? Okay? And as you're imagining it, imagine what you would hear if you were in that place right now. Okay? Maybe is there a particular smell? Does it smell like something? Like maybe your grandma's home cooking. Maybe she's baking some cookies for you. Okay? Are you imagining what your favorite place looks like, sounds like, smells like, maybe feels like? All right, well, I invite you to open your eyes again. And can you describe to me what your place, your imaginary place that you were imagining in your mind, not an imaginary place, a real place, that you were imagining looks like, sounds like, feels like? Can you describe that to me? Or maybe you can describe it to a friend that's sitting beside you in Sunday school, or your parents, or your siblings, okay? I want you to take a few minutes and go ahead and describe the place you're imagining right now, okay? Well, I think I hear some wonderful places that you guys imagined. Do you guys know what a vision is? In today's Bible story, we saw how God gave Peter a vision, right? To teach him something important. And so just like that, a vision is like a dream, except a vision doesn't come from your own imagination. And in today's Bible story, we learned that it was a way of God sending a message to Peter. And that is what a vision is. All right, well, let's go on and do our discussion questions and figure out what else we learned. We learned about vision, and let's find out what else you guys learned from today's Bible lesson. You guys ready? Okay. Question number one is, to whom did God send an angel? That's right, it was Cornelius. Okay, question number two, what did the angel tell Cornelius to do? Yes, the angel told Cornelius to send some people into the city to find Peter. Good job. Okay, question number three. What happened when Peter told Cornelius his family and friends about Jesus? Yeah, it was incredible. They believed. Okay, question number four. Why did God give Peter a vision? Yeah, God gave Peter a vision to tell him something important, and that something important was to show Peter that the good news of Jesus is for all people. Good job. All right, and question number five, which is our big picture question for the entire unit, is what is the gospel? My friends, this is probably one of the most important questions in all of our faith because this is a key component of the Christian faith, is this question of what is the gospel or the good news, okay? Because the gospel is the good news that God sent his son Jesus into the world to rescue sinners, okay? All people are sinners, so the good news about Jesus is for everyone. And God wants believers, people who already know Jesus, to tell everyone about the good news of Jesus, no matter who they are and what they do. So I encourage you, my friends, that you can share about Jesus to anyone and everyone you wish. All right, good job. All right, my friends, before we get into our craft, this week we have an activity, okay? So I'm gonna need all of you guys to stand on up, okay? You're gonna stand up. And this is what we're gonna do. I'm gonna call out an action, okay? But you should only do the action I call out if I repeat the command three times, okay? So for example, the first one will be jump. But if I say jump, then you don't have to jump. But if I say jump three times, if I say jump, 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 then you're gonna do the action and jump around, okay? You think you can do it? All right, here we go. Okay, so the first one is jump, jump, jump. Good jumping. All right, and next thing you're gonna do is spin, spin, spin. Okay, and you're gonna tap your toes. Oh, I got some of you. Only do the action if I repeat it three times, okay? Just like this, clap, clap, clap. All right, good job. Okay, and pat your head. Oh, you guys are too smart. I didn't get you. Okay, you're gonna sit, sit. Oh, did I get some of you? That was only twice. Okay, you're gonna hop on one foot. Hop on one foot. Hop on one foot. Okay, and you're gonna wiggle, wiggle. Ah, drats. Okay, how about dance? Ah, oh, I did that too slow. Okay, how about touch your toes, touch your toes, touch your toes. Okay. And you're gonna tickle your armpits. No, nobody wants to tickle their armpits. Okay, how about you reach for the sky? Reach for the sky? Reach for the sky! Good job. Okay, and you're gonna do jumping jacks, jumping jacks, jumping jacks! Whoa, that's good. Jumping jacks. Okay, I'd ask all my friends to sit, sit, sit. Good job. Are you guys hot? You guys all exercised? Good job listening to the commands. You guys are really good. Figuring out whether I did it three times or twice or once, that takes good listening skills. I'm very impressed. I wonder, do your parents ever have to tell you something three times? Maybe 300 times? You know that your parents or maybe your teachers are saying something important if they repeat it more than once. And if they repeat it three times, you better listen up, because I bet you it's something really important. And in today's Bible lesson, God showed Peter a vision three times, remember, to teach him something very important. That's how we know it was extra important and we should listen up, right? And what did God show? That's right. God showed Peter that the good news about Jesus is for everyone, all people. Because at that time, some people thought that the good news was only for Jewish people. But we find out here that the good news is for all people. God wants believers to tell the good news of Jesus to everyone, no matter who they are or what they do, because Jesus is Lord of all. Good job, my friends. All right, well, let's head on over to the craft table and do our craft for today. All right, my friends, welcome to Craft Corner. For this week's craft, you are going to draw an outline of a person, or you can use a template we sent in the lesson plan from 2 weeks ago. It looks like this. Okay, but you can go ahead and draw your own outline. And you're gonna need some construction paper in various colors of skin tone. So you could go from black, dark brown, light brown, medium brown, tan, white, yellow, all the different colors, and you're going to cut them into little squares or circles or irregular shapes, or you can even rip them, okay? And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna mix up all the colors, and with the glue stick, you are going to stick them on so it completely covers the figure in all the different shades. And this is to represent that the gospel is for everyone from around the world. No matter what you look like, the gospel is for you, because God is king over everyone. Okay? And by doing this, we're making a mosaic. So a big picture out of tiny little ones. And it can be kind of like this. So this is a sample. Afterwards, you can put some googly eyes and draw a happy face, but it could end up looking like that. Or however yours turns out is just fine. And now for my friends who are with groups, maybe you're with your siblings and you're with your family, or I'm specifically thinking of my friends in the Sunday school room, I have an alternative way of doing this. What I want you to do is get a big piece of paper, and you can ask one of the friends to lie down, and you can trace a life-size person, okay? So you're gonna go ahead and trace that one friend, so you have a big figure of a person, okay? And then you're all gonna work together to create this image of somebody that represents everybody from around the world. You can use the shred up pieces of paper, or you can even color it in, and you're gonna work together to create a mosaic that reminds us of today's big picture question, which is that the good news of the gospel is for everyone around the world. So can you work together to do that? Amazing. And you know, God calls his church, his people, believers, to also work in unity, to work together in order that we may share the good news of the gospel to all people. Okay? All right, you can go ahead and have some fun. All right, everyone. I hope you guys had a wonderful time in Sunday school this week. I sure did. And I hope you learned that the good news of Jesus is for everyone, all people around the world. And I'm sitting on the ground here right now because I'm encouraging you guys, if you guys have a globe, okay, or if you have maybe a ball that you could ask your parents if you could do something, Okay, I'm gonna ask you to ask your parents if you can write on a ball, or if you have a globe even better, and write down some names of some places in the world, maybe some countries or cities or whatever you know around the world. Okay, and you're gonna use that ball the next time you pray and throughout the week as you pray to roll it around on the ground in front of you and just stick your thumb on it at one point. Okay, and whatever, wherever your thumb lands, so maybe you put on that ball India, and your thumb lands on India, then I encourage you to pray for that country. Pray that the good news of Jesus will be spread throughout that country, and you pray for them to know the good news of the gospel. Okay? So today, I'm going to pray for all of you, my friends in Good Fruit Ministry. So would you join me in prayer? Okay. Well, the prayer hand song goes like this, okay? The right hand is flying up so high, shoom. The left hand is flying up so high, shoom. They meet and squeeze in the sky. They fall down, now close your eyes. Thank you, God. Thank you for the lesson that you taught us today. Thank you for your good word that is all true. Lord, I pray that as we learn the lessons in the Bible, that we can come to know the gospel more and come to realize that you sent Jesus Christ down to earth in order that you may save all of us, not just a select few, not just the few people who listen the best or pray the hardest, God, or sing the best or whatever it is, God, but you are the King of all people, no matter what. No matter where they live, no matter what they do, no matter what they think, no matter what they say, God, you love us all. So we thank you that you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, down into earth to give us the good news. God, we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, everybody. Before we go, let's sing the goodbye song and say goodbye to each other, okay? It goes like this. Goodbye, Nari. Bye, guys. Goodbye. Who's there? Can you shout out your name real loud? Okay. Goodbye, everyone. Sunday school is done. I will see you all next week. Bye.